with the present World Chess Championship qualifier worth millions of dollars in progress, two games to go. We find the astonishing veteran with over 2,000 games of chess played, Ivanchuk, deciding the World Championship in effect with two games to go. He wins a 90-move game because he's a person of integrity. He could just take a pass. He's totally out of the money. His money's guaranteed. He's finished in terms of winning the world title in this tournament, the right to play for the world title. So what does he do? He says, I'm not good to be a doormat. He fights Carlsen for 90 moves. The game goes endlessly, and he outplays the highest-rated player in the world, defeats him, and suddenly rockets the amazing player, the veteran Kramnik, who beat Kasparov, the greatest performance ever recorded. He beat Kasparov in 16 games without losing a single game. So you have Kramnik now ahead by 1.5 point, Carlsen second, and with Ivanchuk out of the running, but nevertheless having performed beyond belief. So you have Ivanchuk, one of the truly great players of all time, in his finest hour, showing that he wants to play well and still can. His magnificent 90-move victory over Carlsen will be remembered for all time. This tournament is really something. I honestly believe everything indicates, look at the games, don't take my word for it, the greatest tournament ever played. The players seem to have come there with spears and knives. I wonder how it is to walk out of the room to go to the grocery store or local cafes. They must be giving each other hostile attitudes. At this point, from a theatrical point of view, you have Norwegian chess tournaments, multi-million dollar tournaments, guaranteed because Carlsen plays in them or is associated with them, or the organizers who promote Carlsen events are associated with them. That's huge money. And now you have a new superstar, Kramnik, returning from supposedly career death. Kramnik, now the number two player in the world. Kramnik able to go from city to city playing Carlsen in the next 3 months, along with seven other players, all being made rich. If for any reason Kramnik wins this tournament, you have a series of superstars. Anand, the world chess champion, living in India, cleaning up as a result of this without making a move, managed magnificently by his wife Aruna. They're both going to make millions regardless of what happens here. You have Carlsen, the national hero, an unbelievable player, a programmable outlaw who nevertheless is worth millions in just a programmable outlaw who nevertheless is worth millions of dollars in just fashion industry representation. So you've got this, and now you've got the other people like Ivanchuk in the wings, who have played two of the most important games of all time. It was Ivanchuk who handed Armenia the World Team Championship last year by beating the outstanding Chinese player and handing, by tiebreak, Armenia its unprecedented third World Team Championship for tiny Armenia. Every child in Armenia is now taught by law to play chess in the school system of Armenia. It's coming here, folks, also. And so this is a major, major development with Ivanchuk and people like him now known to the public more than ever, with two superstars, Kramnik, Anand, hovering around Carlsen, the number one player in the world. All of this has happened because of one game played yesterday. And in terms of money, everyone hopes that Carlsen would somehow have a chance to win this tournament with two games to go. The odds, according to Jeff Sonas, are really apparently true. 65% Kramnik will win the right to play for the world championship and over $1 million in money, guaranteed, even if he loses to Anand. 35% chance that Carlsen will win the right to play with two games remaining. And finally, the big thing, in the chance of a Veronian, about not one chance in 5,000 that he would be able to win the tournament with two games remaining, all on one game played yesterday. And the great game between Aronian and Kramnik yesterday has to be recalled. It went on and on, was decided in the end game when a pawn could have been a distant outside pass pawn, but unfortunately Aronian pushed the wrong pawn to g6 instead of a pawn to h6, and that cost him the world championship bid. It's a game that will live forever in his mind, and what a game that was too. Don't take my word for it. Look at all the games on Chess Lab and many other places. You won't be sorry.